Okay, so that should be at the halfway point. Let's take another look. What's this damn thing doing? And now it's at a quarter tank. So this thing has got the wrong electrical value.
Go!
So we've been waiting on this fuel sending unit, and it has arrived, and it is exactly like the one I took out. It's got the return on it for the fuel injection. There's only one company that makes this, and this is Auto Metal Direct, and they're the ones who made the last one. And here's the problem with this part. All the information I've done on this thing, potentiometer reads wrong. At full, it shows half tank. So there's no, and the other one was doing the exact same thing. From what I've been able to find, this is the only company that makes this particular part, which is a 64 Chevelle sending unit for this gas tank with the return. And that definitely sucks. So no matter what, you know, full tank, I'm going to have show half. I'm doing some research, but I don't think it's possible to recalibrate this. From what I'm reading, you'd have to add electricity to it to bring it up to the point where it would need to be, and then up to 90. Everything I've read, nobody's been able to figure that out or do it, other than put it back in, obviously, and roll with it. Now, the other one wasn't working anyways, the potentiometer areas. I showed you that in the previous, earlier in the video. Those were scratched off and worn out. So this car was restored sometime before 2011. So 11 years, 12 years, 13 years is how long one of these lasts, apparently. But we'll have something. I think that the digital Dakota gauges that you can buy correct this problem, or you can go into the software that's fully adjustable and correct this problem. So I plan to do Dakota digital gauges at a later date, but right now we're going to put this in, get this gas tank back in the car, and get this car back on the ground so we can move forward. Anyway, here we go.
I ask him, Chris, why in the hell are you cleaning an area nobody's gonna see? And it's mostly to prevent future rust down the line. Once dirt builds up, it holds moisture, and it just prevents rust from building up at a later date. And then you say, but Chris, you live in Southern California. There's no rain, there's no moisture. Yeah, well, the goal is to drive this thing cross country at some point. Still hoping, and I would really love to drive this thing, and I don't care about weather, so this thing hopefully will see some weather down the line. It would be nice. We'll see. A little bit of burn rubber. Oh man, I guess I gotta clean that.
Idiot.
plumbed this car before, zip tied the power wire to the gas line. So the wire that powers the fucking fuel pump is zip tied to the gas line. No. You route those separately. Those don't go together. Okay? Bad. So, I got one line, comes under the frame, and then back around over the top of the frame, over the top of the axle, and we're hoping it's going to reach its mounting spot. We're going to check that in a minute. But that's what we got, and we got it mounted down, so it's away from the exhaust and away from the suspension. So let's go take a look in the back. Okay, so there's its mounting spot. Have to do some adjustments, but we'll get it up on that frame up there. Get this thing heat shielded, and we'll get it away from that exhaust. It'll work. All right. On to the next hose. Okay. Goddamn thing. Still spitting gas on me. Take the same route here. That's the gas line. This is the return. This would be a nice time to have a hoist, I'll tell you what. It's a piece of protective rubber around this thing. There, feel a little better about that. That way it's not rubbing on the frame right there. Yeah, that's cool. Okay, so had to do some off-camera work. I basically pulled out the entire hose assembly and fitted this over the top of it. Heat guard to protect, because we're going right over the top of the exhaust. Why this is this way, it's pretty shitty, to be honest with you. We're gonna have to deal with this down the line. I really would like to hard line this thing. There's a rubber line the whole way to the front of the car. You can see the fuel filter right there, and I would at least like to hard line it from the fuel filter forward, and maybe all the way back to here. But we moved the fuel pump that way a little. To it used to be mounted at this end, which put this elbow right against the exhaust, so we moved it over a little bit. I also have this other shield right here, which I might further shield this whole thing. We'll see, something like that maybe. We'll see here in a little bit. But we've rerouted. We're around the frame, around the suspension, around the muffler. Yeah, pretty happy with that. Back on to getting the gas tank in. But yeah, we still got to work on a bit of ground for that too. Gotta make always make sure that this little tab is folded under this piece of the bodywork. Otherwise the strap will just bend and pull out. It's kind of the lock-in. Put it on both sides. So we've now got pump back in place. We just got to deal with the ground wire. We've got the lines back in place. We got to deal with securing this so this can't be moving around. This is the gas line to the fuel injection and the return. We're gonna somehow figure that out. And then we got to get the power line back over here, which is hanging down way over there. We're going to rerun it because I wasn't happy where it was going. That's going to come over to here. And then I think we're done back here. A lot of times you'll see me use a lighter to shrink tubing, but not this close to the gas tank. We got a damn fan going there trying to keep the garage cool, and right now it's blowing the heat away. This is the ground splice. All right, it's all back together. That was quite the ordeal. Gas tank out, gas tank in, replaced the sending unit, rerouted all of the wiring, rerouted all of the plumbing for the fuel pump. If you can see right here, the wire, the power wire, is still with the fuel line, but it's running through a piece of hose, so it's not hard zip tied to the line, and that goes all the way up and over. The fuel line now does not go right next to the muffler, which is a good thing. It now goes up the side of the frame. And I'm very happy about all that. Also put some heat material onto the gas line and moved over the fuel pump this direction a little. Used to be over here, now it's over here. Give a little bit more clearance away from that exhaust pipe. I never had any problem with it, but that just should not be. So that's definitely gonna help. Redid my wiring over here, redid my ground, and I think we're ready to go put some gas in this thing, put her on the ground, and do some burnouts. Well, that was a hellacious amount of work to still end up with a non-working gas gauge. I'm pretty bummed about that. I got all that other stuff done, so I'm really happy about it. For all of you who stuck around this long, I really appreciate it. Please consider liking and subscribing. Maybe consider picking up a t-shirt. Link in the description below. And see you in the next one. Peace.